हेलो एंड नमस्ते। माय नेम इज़ गौतम बेहरा एंड टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन हीट ट्रीटमेंट ऑन ग्रे कास्ट आयरन। सो वी हैव नॉलेज दैट वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हीट ट्रीटमेंट दैट मीन्स इट इम्पैक्ट्स सम बेनिफिशियल प्रॉपर्टी और सम बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट टू द मटेरियल। सो there are many different heat treatments are given to the gray cast iron for different purpose, where some purpose is like removing the internal stresses and some purpose is to increase the wear resistance, hardness, to increase the strength, to increase the machinability, so on. So we'll discuss one by one. So first heat treatment is the stress relieving heat treatment given to the gray cast iron. So the name is suggesting that the internal stresses which basically developed during solidification will get removed during this stress relieving heat treatment. This treatment is carried out basically at temperature of 538 to 565 degree centigrade. And it has been seen that if we keep the steel, the cast iron at this temperature for 1 hour, 80% to 85% of stress will get removed. The next, we'll discuss about the annealing heat treatment on the gray cast iron. So annealing, the word annealing comes means we understand that it brings softening into the material. It decreases the strength and hardness somewhat, right? So annealing heat treatment on the gray cast iron is done basically to enhance the machinability property by decreasing the strength and hardness, obviously. So it is basically done by either decomposing the eutectoid carbide into different microstructures like ferrite and graphite or perlite and graphite, or maybe completely eliminating this phase. So now we'll discuss, that means we have many kind of or many types of this annealing heat treatment given to the gray cast iron. So first one is that is ferritizing annealing. So in the ferritizing annealing, obviously as I told, it improves the machinability. Here the perlitic carbides get transformed into ferrite and graphite, and this is carried out at a temperature of 700 to 760 degrees centigrade, and the sample is cooled at 100 degrees centigrade per hour. Basically, or to 300 degree centigrade per hour, it depends. Then next is the full annealing. So full annealing, we understand we have ferritizing annealing. Then why we need full annealing? Full annealing, we understand that means we have to go to high temperature compared to that of ferritizing annealing. So which is basically at a temperature of 760 to 900 degree centigrade, higher than that of ferritizing annealing. This is done because at 760 degree centigrade, if alloying elements will be there in the cast iron, it suppresses the decomposition of eutectoid carbide. So that is perlitic carbides. So we have to increase the decomposition. So that's why we are going to high temperature. That is called full annealing. The next is graphitizing annealing. So graphitizing annealing is graphitizing annealing is basically done to convert the eutectoid carbide or massive carbides into basically perlite and graphite rather than ferrite and graphite. It is perlite and graphite. So it is basically done at a very high temperature, that is above 900 degrees centigrade, that is 900 to 955 degrees centigrade. And at such a high temperature, these massive carbides basically get soluble into the austenite. So after soluble into the austenite phase, when the gray cast iron is cooled, this will decompose into perlite and graphite. So and the cooling is done at a temp that is 110 degree centigrade per hour. Next is normalizing. So as the name suggests, normalizing basically given to improve the strength and hardness basically. So here also the gray cast iron strength and hardness will increase on normalizing. And basically, what happens during pre-heat treatment or post-heat treatment of welded components, the edge cast property get lost. That can be regained due to normalizing also. This is carried out at a temperature of 885 degree centigrade to 925 degree centigrade. And if alloying elements will be there, that is molybdenum, chromium, nickel, they enhance the strength during annealing process. Okay, we'll continue in the next video better.